This is Jared Horak for today's racingdigest.com. My today's Racing Digest video series continues Saturday, December 21st and Sunday, December 22nd. We're going to do stakes races back-to-back days at Aqueduct Racetrack. We're going to start with Saturday, December 21st, and we're going to do the eighth race from Aqueduct. It's going to be the Queens County Stakes for three-year-olds and up, and they're going to be traveling a mile and an eighth on the main track. Let's pull up the fast figs for this race right now. We've been doing the fast figs for today's Racing Digest for quite some time. The fast figs is a combination of class rating, speed rating, all rolled into one. The higher the number, the better. And the top fast fig horses for this race, a Major Cabby with a 136. Stan the Man, your morning line favorite, with a 133. Backside of the Moon with a 132, and Han Sense with a 131. So Major Cabby has a 3-point edge in this race. Now I'll give out my top four contenders and then wagering strategies. Number five, Backside of the Moon, is going to be my fourth choice. He's 7-2 morning line. He exits back-to-back victories in 1 mile races at Aqueduct. And in his last race, he was claimed out of that race for $100,000, and they're going to jump him right into the stakes race. Now, this one has won four races overall at Aqueduct. He's won at this mile and an eighth distance before, and he'll probably be coming from off the pace in this spot. My third choice in here, the one, Roaming Union. He's 8-1 morning line. He does like this track. He likes this distance as well. And I like his running style versatility. He can go up there and be part of the pace, but most likely he's going to save ground stalking the pace in this spot. He's also going to reconnect with his winning rider, Eric Cancel. Like I said, he's probably going to save ground stalking the pace, and at 8-1, he could at least spice up the exotics. Now we'll get to my top two contenders. Number two, Stan the Man, is going to be my second choice in here. He's your 9-5 favorite. He's making his first start in more than 6 months, so he hasn't run in a while. He does like Aqueduct, and he should be forwardly placed. Now, coming off the layoff at this distance, maybe he's going to be the one that's going to try to go out there and set the pace. And he's going to hang in there as long as he can. But I'm going to make number four, Major Cabby, the top fast fig horse, my top pick in this race. He's 5-2 morning line, ahead of him a few starts back at Keeneland. He captured three of his last five dirt routes now. And he's really dangerous when he can get out there and control the pace. Now, I'm not sure that he's going to necessarily do that in here with Stan the Man, but with Stan the Man drawn inside of him, I think Major Cabby is going to be up close. He won a 1 mile dirt race at Del Mar. He didn't set the pace, he sat in second. So I think if Stan the Man wants to go, I think they're going to be comfortable sitting right outside of that one, right off his flank, and they're going to try to use maybe their recency and their stamina to maybe try to get past that one. Last time out, he chased the pace. He ended up finishing fifth in an 11 horse field in the Grade 1 Clark at Churchill Downs. This race is not nearly as tough. His best recent Today's Racing Digest final ratings in his last three starts, he had a 140 in the Clark, and then in back-to-back wins at Keeneland, he got a 150 and a 161, both of those races at a mile and a 16th. So Major Cabby in here should be forwardly placed, and he's got a good shot to hang in there and maybe win this one for trainer Peter Miller. Here's how we're going to play this race. For the wagers, we're going to make a win wager on number four, Major Cabby. We're going to play an exacta with number four, Major Cabby, on top of the one, Roman Union, the two, Stand the Man, the five, Backside of the Moon. We're gonna key Stan the Man in second in my next exacta using my other three contenders on top of him. That'll be the 1, 4, and 5 over the two. And then a trifecta, top two choices, 2 and 4, Stan the Man and Major Cabby, 2-4 with 2-4. And then we're going to put the other two, the 1, Roman Union, and the 5 in third in the trifecta. So that's 2-4 with 2-4 with 1-5 for that trifecta. Let's jump over to Sunday. December 22nd at Aqueduct. Their feature race on Sunday will be their ninth race of the Gravesend Handicap for the Gravesend Stakes. Three-year-olds and up, 6 furlongs on the main track. Jason Service has two solid contenders in this race. Firenze Fire is going to be your strong favorite in here. He's the class of the field, and he's exiting a nice victory. That was at Park's non-graded stakes race. He just rolled that day. He's probably going to be towards the inside, chasing the pace. Would not be surprised at all if he won this one. His odds are going to be very low. But his stablemate, I think, has a shot to win this one, the 6, Happy Farm. And he's going to be my top choice over Firenze Fire. And Happy Farm, he's going after his 5th straight win. He's been very sharp since Jason Service claimed this one. He stepped up in class last time, and he scored to win his 4th race in a row in the Grade 3 Fall Highweight at Aqueduct on December 8th. I liked him that day. I played him. He is 7-1. I got nice win price on that one. I liked him, and then I liked Wonderful Light, who's also in this race. So they were the two horses I liked in the fall highway. They both ran well. Happy Farm won that one. He drew well in this race. There's not a ton of pace. I can see him either setting the pace or being very close to the pace on the outside like he was last time. Maybe he can get a jump on his stablemate Firenze Fire and pull off the minor upset. And then I mentioned the four Wonderful Light, my third choice. This one's very consistent, especially at the 6 furlong distance. He finished second in the fall highway last time. He's a stalker, and he can finish, most likely he will finish somewhere in the top three. We will make a win wager on the 6 Happy Farm. Play an exacta Happy Farm, the 6 on top of the 2 Firenze Fire, the 4 Wonderful Light. We're going to put the 4 Wonderful Light and the 6 Happy Farm on top of the 2 Firenze Fire, and then a trifecta. We're going to put the top two contenders in first and second, the 2 and 6, Firenze Fire and Happy Farm. That's 2-6 with 2-6, and then we'll key the 4 Wonderful Light in third. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up, subscribe to my YouTube channel, make some comments in the comment section. Who do you like in some of these stakes races at Aqueduct on December 21st and December 22nd? That will wrap up this week. I will be back next week with another stakes race from around the country.